I'll accept that stipulation.
Okay, so stipulate. You call my instructions with stipulations, judges? Very well. Proceed.
As a matter of fact, you testified in your deposition that there were some checks from some recycling company or a steel company. You remember testifying to that?
I do, but I don't remember what the name of the place was.
Okay. After the checks are found, as I understand it, you go to the emporium, correct?
Okay. Yes.
Don't say okay, because I'm not asking you to agree with me. I just want to know.
Yes.
And then you go to another place on 35, correct?
Yes.
That's what you testified to, correct? In front of us. That's what you said?
Yes.
Okay. Now, as I understand it, the next day, you were working back on the premises, is that correct?
I don't recall if it was the next day or not.
Well, you said, and I could be wrong, but at some point in time, you said that you were working and Keith drove by, correct?
He came there, yes.
He came there. Was that the next day?
It may have been.
Well, the last day that Keith worked, wasn't that the day that the safe was opened? Page 41, please.
Of the deposition.
Yeah,
62.
Right.
Okay.
Got it?
Yep.
After the day that you went to the antique emporium with Keith, your answer was yes. Keith did not come back to the job. No. Is that right? Yes. That's what you testified to, correct?
Yes.
So the last time that Keith worked, at least according to you back then, was the day you went to the emporium, correct?
Yes.
And you said that on that day, the day after Keith came and drove to 1602 Fourth Avenue, correct?
Yes.
And he gave you $2,500. That's what you testified to, correct?
Yes.
And then you testified in your deposition that Keith told you when he gave you that $2,500, it was from John Burke, is that correct?
Yes.
And did you thank John Burke for giving you that $2,500?
No.
Well, you saw him that week, correct?
No.
You didn't see him that week?
I didn't see John.
Wasn't he coming around daily?
Not from what I recall.
Well, did he give you a check for that week?
No.
He didn't?
No.
You also, in your statement to the police, your first statement to the police,
which was
the statement of June you tell your stepfather that John Burke had given you $2,500 through Keith?
I don't remember.
Well, did you talk to your stepfather after you got, as you indicate, the $2,500 from Keith?
I imagine, I don't remember.
Is it now your testimony that although you gave that testimony under oath at your deposition, and although you gave that testimony to the police, that that's false?
Can you rework that?
Are you now saying that what you said under oath at a deposition and what you said in a statement to the police, that is not true?
I'm going to object to the breadth of the question. Are you asking that specific?
Do you understand what I'm asking?
Not really.
Okay.
Let me see if I can make it a little easier. You told the police that Keith Schaefer gave you $2,500, right?
Yes.
And you also told the police that you got that $2,500 and Keith Schaefer told you it was from John Burke, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Is that true?
It was in my statement. I don't recall it. I mean,
well, you also gave a deposition, is that correct?
Yes.
And in that deposition, you put your hand on the Bible and you swore to tell the truth, correct?
Yes.
And you also said in that deposition that Keith Schaefer gave you $2,500 and told you it was from John Burke, correct?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Is that the same thing? I do not recall. It's been 6 years.
Saying, as I recall, that Keith Schaefer promised you $10,000, correct?
Yes.
So, if I'm to understand you correctly, and please let me know if I'm off base here, Keith Schaefer, at least through your deposition and through your statement, said, here's $25 from John Burke. Right?
$25?
$2,500.
Yes.
And then where did the other $7,500 come from? We told you he was going to give you $10,000, correct?
Yes.
And is it your testimony that he told you when he gave you $2,500 that that was from John Burke?
Yes.
So did you ask him about the other $7,500?
When I spoke to him.
Why didn't you? You never mentioned that in your deposition, correct?
Right.
You never mentioned it in any of the certifications you did, correct?
That's right.
And you never mentioned it in either one of the statements you gave to the police, correct?
That's right.
But you tell us that you went to Keith's house to ask about work. Is that your testimony?
I believe so.
Well, I'm just asking, is that what you're telling us? You don't need to look at anything.
I mean, I don't remember much, so you're...
You remember going to Keith's house?
Yes, I do.
Okay, you remember telling us that you went there because there was no work? You wanted to talk about work? Thank you.
guess I...
Where was Keith living when you went to his house?
Burktown?
And as I understand it, Keith had not been back to work, at least that's what you said back then, since the day you went to the Emporium, correct?
Yeah.
So Keith lives in Bricktown, you live in Neptune, and the premises is in Asbury Park, correct?
Yes.
A short distance, correct? From
yes.
Where you live. Why didn't you just go back to the place and ask about work?
Because I wasn't in contact with John.
You weren't in contact with John?
No.
Do you have any way to contact him?
Not at first.
Would you do me a favor? Would you go to page 40 of your deposition?
Okay.
Tell me when you're there.
So.
Can you remember being asked this question? Remember or not. We asked this question, was John continuing to come to the job on a daily basis? Your answer was, at that point, I mean, I don't want to say he came every day, but he would call me, and check in.
Can I ask whether he was on the mind?
Can you ask what?
What mind are you reading?
I'm reading page 40, line 16. I'm sorry. Line 19 through 23. Did you say that?
Yes.
All right, so John was calling you every day?
No.
Well, that's what you said.
This was after I continued to work.
This was what?
When I continued to work afterwards.
Well, when did you continue to work afterwards?
After all this pre-statement and stuff,
yeah.
Like when we went down and did everything, then he continued to use me. What?
So let me get this straight. So you had no contact with John Burke after you found?
No. Beforehand. John. I used to get my checks through Keith.
You got all your checks from Keith?
Yes.
Okay. So my question is, when was the last check you got from Keith?
Prior to this.
Prior to what? Today? Yeah, I get that.
Prior to the finding the safe. I mean,
you know what?
I don't know. I don't recall. Like, it's...
Byers, you went to Keith Schaefer's house in Bricktown to get money from him, is that correct?
To find out about work.
Excuse me?
I went there to see it because Keith was not answering me.
So, you went there, so it's your testimony that you went to Brick Township, Mr. Schaefer's house, to get some understanding of when you were going to get work?
I did ask him about the money too, yes, but
so
I did.
You went there to ask about work and to get money, correct?
Right.
And he told you, in essence, get lost, correct?
Yes.
He told you what was found was his, correct? No. And you said, well, I'm going to contact Burke. Did you tell him that? How did you get Burke's phone when you texted him?
Well, I don't remember offhand.
Did you have his phone?
I want to say I got it from his either. I don't want to assume it's been, I really don't remember where I got it from. I'm not going to put words in my mouth.
Well, you're not going to put words in your mouth. I'm certainly not going to put words
in your mouth. Well, I'm not going to sit here and make something up.
You know how much time elapsed from the time you found the safe to the time you texted Burke?
No.
Before you went to the police, you had discussed, had you spoken to Mr. Burke?
Yes.
Did he come to your house?
Yes.
All right, so Mr. Burke comes to your house, you have a discussion with him, and then at some point in time you went to the police?
Yes.
Had you spoken to Mr. Lee Levitt from the time before you spoke to the police?
Couldn't tell you.
Now you indicated you're not working for the Burks now, is that correct?
Correct.
Is that because you stopped showing up for work?
No, they said there was nothing else to do.
Very well. last question. But you knew John's number. Go to page 42. I got it from my stepfather. Was that the answer you gave at your deposition?
Yeah.